Hello, this is Ian, and you're watching Expression UG. I'm a web developer by profession. I also act, though I'm more biased towards comedy. I love movies. I've watched movies since I was a kid. I've always wanted to be like those guys in the movies you've seen. I love the power to create things from scratch. Uganda, the acting industry, or the arts generally, are still low and virgin. People don't believe in artists. Unlike other developed countries, people do not know yet how powerful technology can be in their lives. For example, people who have businesses, they don't know how important a website can be to them. They don't know how much they can reach out to the market using technology these days. They think technology is for the whites, technology is for the very, very brilliant people, very sharp people. The generic web designing business is supposed to be a step-by-step process where sit down with a client, or a client comes to you with their need, and then you identify what their exact needs could be in as far as the website. Then you go back, sit down, design what could be a blueprint of the work that you're going to produce. You talk to them again and say, I have this, what do you think? It's like a plan of a house. When you want to build a house, you come with a plan, talk about the plan, then they tell you, okay, this could work, add this, add more, yeah. Then you go down and start developing the real website. It takes time, it takes effort, it takes resource, it takes research, because we have to use code, we have to use modules that at times are not very readily available. So it's a long phase, but people do not know. If they like it, yes. That is when usually we begin discussing price. Unfortunately, though, price is usually supposed to be at the beginning of the process. And usually we find a hard time negotiating. At times we find ourselves getting very little for the work, since it is usually at the end of the process that we ask for the price. So we usually are at a losing side. We feel manipulated. People like us who develop from scratch have that challenge. People think, I'll go to someone X, someone Y who will do this for me at a cheaper cost. So we lose out a lot. We also have another problem of people not knowing whether they will need a site. So there are cases where we have to pitch ideas to people. You look at their business and you're like, I think we can do this, we can do that, we can do this. But remember, if it's someone's company and they have their structure, their goals, their objectives, you're trying to fit yourself into their goals that maybe they didn't have that in plan. So it's bureaucratic at times to get you running in their system. And I think for everything, sensitization is key. People need to get out of their cocoons, they need to learn, they need to know, they need to open their perspectives to things and know that these things can be done. It's possible for a Ugandan to create Facebook, to act and be like Denzel Washington or anyone else. I think governments should support actors, should support the arts, to make people realize that yes, something can be done. If handled well, such fields can also earn the country, can also contribute to the country's GDP in a way. I think it has majorly been because of cutting down of trees without laws to govern that. Currently, yes, there's some level of desertification in our country. We've seen people dying because of hunger and starvation as a result of lack of rain, lack of, you know, water, and that's all caused because of climate change. Yeah, so I think the best way artists can contribute is promote awareness in any ways they can, or even get involved in planting trees.